Deciding a course for your studies in Canada or any other country for that matter can be a tough affair. In this video, I am going to show you how you can choose a course with your own research in a few easy steps. I will cover how to choose a course depending upon your previous education, your interest and job prospects. Hello everyone, I am Soumi Rawal. Let's start this video. In the current scenario, the job markets are very unstable, especially after the COVID-19 impact. There has been layoffs in huge numbers. So what course should the prospective student take that can guarantee a job in their field and not some minimum wage jobs? The answer is your skills and the job demand. Look beyond 10 years. Do you think your job will still be in demand or you can be replaced by a software, for example? Do you or will you have the skill set to survive and be competitive in that job field? Answer these questions and you will know. Now coming to how you can choose a course in Canada, we'll take the case of a BCom student who's interested to do a 1 year postgraduate diploma. We'll call him student A. It is not compulsory but advised to take up a course which is parallel to your graduation. That way you can add up to your skills and also get your visa approved easily. Now the student A has several options at his hands, but most are not similar to his previous education. For example, a commerce student can take up courses like human resources, business analytics or general business. I would suggest you take up a skill intensive course which is niche based and targeted. For example, you shouldn't take courses like general business because they will not help in building up your skills. So now let's find out the different tools of how you can find out more about the course. For our current purposes, let's assume student A has decided to pursue business analytics course. The first step would be to find out the demand of the business analytics professionals. For this, there is a free and a Sarkari tool available, which is a website that is called Job Bank. I am attaching the link for the same in the description below.
Now we are on the website of the Government of Canada's Job Bank. The website address is also given in the description. It is jobbank.ca. Now you go on the third tab, the trend analysis, and click on occupations. This tab will open. Now you can search according to your territory and postal code also, but right now we are giving a general search. Now we'll put in the NOC code of student A or the job profile name of the student A, that is business analyst or data analyst. We'll put in that. Now we'll search. So the database analyst in Canada is NOC code 2172. This code can be used to apply for your work visas or also your PRs. So for our case right now, it is not important. Now you can see the description of the job, the various prospects that are available. You can click over here. The available jobs right now, there are 114 advertised in Canada. The university, the requirements of the job, the hourly wages and the skills that are required for the particular job. Now we'll look at the available jobs right now. There are currently 114 job postings available in Canada. You can also view it according to location. Quebec has 62, Ontario has 22, British Columbia 16, Nova Scotia 5. If you want to see wages, you can also check that. You need to click on wages. So these are the hourly wages in all the provinces and the territories. So in Alberta, the minimum is 28, then highest is 55. That is a good amount. British Columbia 20, 48. This way you can find about all the available job profiles that you want to go for. This way you can finalize your course that you want to do. Now we'll find out the available colleges that give the courses that we want to do. On a simple Google search for our course, that is Business Analytics Diploma in Canada. Now we'll find the first result, that is the college result, the course available. The Business Analytics course is available in Seneca, Centennial and St. Lawrence. We'll click on Seneca College. So So the course starts in January or September. The course code is BAN. It is Ontario College Graduate Certificate, 2 semesters, 1 year. This way you can find out all the information that you need, the admission requirements, the course fees, the costs, and the pathways, the career that you will take. This way you can finalize your college that you want to go for. Use LinkedIn to find out more information about the colleges that we have chosen and the course that we have chosen and their job prospects and the people who are already who have already done the course and where are they working and how are the job prospects for that college. Now I have searched Seneca Business Analytics on the search tab in LinkedIn. You can create your profile over there. If you don't have it, you should have a profile over there. Now when you search it, you'll find several people. These are 8178 results. Many people who work who have done business analytics at Seneca College. So this is the NMLI status that you have, right? This way you can connect to people if you want to and talk to them about the course, take their feedback from the courses to find out the alumni of that particular college. You go to that college, search for that college over here in the search tab, then you can click on alumni, then you can find where they live, where they work. So from Humber College, people who work at Humber College only are 2453, TD 1192, City of Toronto, Roger Communications, CIBC, RBC. So this way you can find out where are the people working who have passed out from your college, the college that you have chosen, right?
I hope I was able to help out with the process. Let me know if you have other questions regarding your education. I have made a separate video about the full visa process in Canada. You can watch the video. I am giving the link in the description below. You can also follow me on Instagram. My handle is somvir_rawal. If you like this video, press the like button and subscribe to my channel. If you didn't like it, let me know what I can improve in the comments. Until next time.